your Carson-Newman Noles.
Well, I'm with Carson-Newman at the NCAA Public Sports Division by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We are also proud to listen to our sporting teams, and we are also proud to listen to our sports teams, and we are also proud to listen to our sports teams, and we are also proud to listen to our sports teams, and we are also proud to listen to our sports teams. Also, consumption or possession of alcohol or beverages at the site of the competition is prohibited. We need to do the events for local operation.
What'd you say, Danny? Do I have
an
alarm?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's see today's starting lineups. First, your visitors from Hickory, the Lenoir-Rhyne Bears. Number 3, Emily Allen. Number 6, Ashley Hawkins. Number 9, Colette Roth. Number 11, Emma Clark. Number 12, Brian Thomas. Number 24, Kinsey Halsey. And the Bear of the Bears is number 41, Haley Carpenter. Lenoir-Rhyne's coach line and Phil Barrett, assisted by Mark Lindbergh.
Oh! Once again, everybody, and welcome to Holt Fieldhouse as we get set for first serve in the South Atlantic Conference quarterfinal rematch from last season. Lenoir-Rhyne, the number four seed a year ago, upending the Eagles after dropping the first set, winning in four against the fifth-seeded Carson-Newman Eagles, effectively ending the year for Carson-Newman. What gives today in this 70th all-time meeting between these two groups? Carson-Newman has won seven of the last nine tussles against the Bears. And we find out tonight if Carson-Newman can keep the good vibes rolling. Carson-Newman has won 18 consecutive sets since just its second loss of the season back on September 13th at Mars Hill. Eagles have won every matchup at home this year. 9-1 to begin the slate in conference play overall. And an opportunity to get this LR side that is one of the best point-scoring groups in the country. Nicole Behringer leads her team into action against this Carson-Newman club that is scorching hot. Carson-Newman six straight sweeps. We'll try to make it a seventh tonight. If that happens, it would be the all-time program record in the category. Just about ready to start things off. Mackenzie Halsey has the ball in her hands, and we're just about ready to light the lamp. Michael Watrang with you with our entire crew here on the Eagle Sports Network. Halsey's floating serve for Hayden Barton. Right side set, played Terry a tap. And then thrown to the corner, and Julia Wheeler can't get back there in time. And it's a very good start for the Bears, taking the first point. Lenoir-Rhyne leads the conference, top 25 nationally in aces per set, 2.22 on average. They're one of the best serving teams in the league. Overpass, dunked to the surface, and already making an early impact. The service game. An overpass by the Eagles, and Mackenzie Halsey has allowed LR to take the first two of the opening set. Knuckling serve, Wheeler backpedaled, all ball has to chase. Cherry gets a pretty good hack at it. It's rescued in the back and flopped over, but a net violation on LR. Carson-Newman on the scoreboard here in the first. Bears started the year 2-3. Since that point have caught fire. 10 of the last 12 have gone in the win column. Last matchup at Tusculum last week was a loss. High arcing pass. Halsey decides to go to the slide, and it works out very perfectly for Emma Clark to shovel it through the back corner. LR has three of the top nine players in the conference in kills per set. There's great options to choose from for Halsey. Ashley Hawkins back to serve. All ball. Once Hildenbrand this time, and it is perfectly executed. Hildenbrand was terrific for Carson-Newman on Tuesday in the sweep of LMU. One kill shy of a triple-double. Second time in her career she'd finish a kill shy of a triple-double. Carson-Newman running the 6-2 formation, meaning Hildenbrand takes swings from the right side when she's in the front row. McKenna Hall serves. This will be a right side set for Colette Romp, the reigning conference offensive player of the week. Here's a three-time offensive conference player of the week in Wheeler. Now Hildenbrand shovels it. Wheeler will step at the 10-foot line, bang it off of the block. Rescue, having a leap forward and punch it over as Allen, the team leader in kills. That's a great diving effort, and it works out for a free ball. Bailey Carpenter, the limestone transfer. Wheeler. This one comes for Rob. All ball will get to it. That's what the assistance of having two setters does for you, but Hildenbrand called for the double violation. Certainly helps for Carson-Newman. In those scenarios where all ball is asked to be able to pick up digs, well, it would take nearly a career effort, but Abby Hildenbrand 19 digs away from 1,000 for her career. Wheeler out of the middle, just ricochets to the left side. Carpenter will feed Romp, who punches at it. Hildenbrand with a left-hand juggle. Out of the middle this time, Barton stepped in front of Cherry, and it falls to the ground. Braylon Faust, the grad student, Statesville, North Carolina, Makes it a 5-2 early start here for the Bears. Fine work early for LR. Carpenter ready to serve. Albaugh, Wheeler. Conference's leader in kills, can't put this one down. Back row attack from Ashley Hawkins. Wheeler another crack at it. This time she makes no mistakes. Has been in double figures in all but one match this year. Top 10 in the country. Kills percent, points percent, total kills. She gets a ton of opportunities for the Eagles. That was her first kill on her fifth swing. 2-point deficit. LR has led the duration so far in the first. Carpenter rescues. Now Romp finesses it over. Eagles free ball after a couple bounces. Right side Romp through the block. Off of the hands of Hildenbrand. Well, this is the thing you have to look at with Lenoir-Rhyne this season. In about half of the team's matches, they've hit at least 250. When it comes to scoring points, few teams better in the entire country. Hildenbrand, right side Wheeler this time around. Great sprawling stop by Hawkins. Thrown to the corner by Tajeri. Wheeler this time for the left pin. Not getting a lot of those traditional starts. And this ball gets pinged through the middle. 7 on the first 10 to the Bears. And it is a really good start for LR here on the road. This is a Bears club that is just 4-3 this season in true road matches. Kieran, though, with the response. That is great work out of the middle. Well, Taylor Kieran has shown the ability throughout her career that she can take over a match, not just in the attack, but as well as in the block. As Julia Wheeler trots back to serve. Halsey wants the slide here, and Julia Wheeler able to scoop it up off Faust's hand. Carpenter feeds Allen. Into the block this time around. And Carson-Newman wins back-to-back points to claw within a pair. Well, typically when these two teams square off, you can expect some classic battles. Here in your 70th all-time meeting. Shank pass and a service ace. Julia Wheeler has Carson-Newman on a 3-0 outburst and a chance to tie the match for the first time today. Wheeler flares. Angled pass, Halsey tried to spike, gets blocked, now back row attack, hits the net, and that is maybe a little fortuitous from Jaden Vaughn, the redshirt freshman from Salisbury, North Carolina. Maintains the edge for the visitors. Bears overall this season, 12-5, 8-2 in conference action. Really good serve, Emily Allen, the freshman from Wooster, Ohio. That is a vicious serve. Let's see if she can duplicate that. That had great pace on it. Very little spin. She did duplicate it, but couldn't keep it in play. You get an ace and you get an error. Net zero gain for LR. Margin maintains at 2 with Hayden Barton back to serve. Former all-conference pick as a libero. Always been one of the best in the league, and she has an ace. Well, her ability to serve has been terrific throughout her career. If you remember, she used to be a flat-footed, stand back by the basketball baseline and heave it to the back. Now she's gone to more of a jump floating serve. And it's forced LR maybe a little bit out of system here, but Hawkins says none of that. She pounds it down. LR with 8 kills early. This is what the Bears do. When they score, they're efficient offensively, hitting nearly 300 in the first. Vaughn, or take that, that's Faust, serves. Molly Lankford, the freshman, pinches it inside of line. Well, when you look at Carson-Newman, there is a great deal of steadiness amongst this group. Abby Hildenbrand began her career at Louisiana Tech. This is her fifth collegiate season. Julia Wheeler started at Tennessee Tech, has one more year of eligibility, listed as a senior this year. But Lankford, a freshman, getting the kill on that time. Left pin set, Hawkins hits the block and gets the kill. Mm-hmm. Lenoir-Rhyne plays that high Division I caliber of play. Get it and put it down. Carson-Newman trying to stick in striking distance. Hawkins, another crack, funnels it through the block. Sherry, does this get a touch? Indeed it does, according to the line judge to our right. Carson-Newman gets the point, back within one. Eagles have been flirting with that margin for the last several rallies. And now it'll be on the all-freshman selection in Blake Cherry to tie this one up. That's a really good pass. Halsey wants the slide. Cherry gobbles it up. Cobb barely got a piece of it. Does get it over. Romp from the right pin. Pummels it down the line. Colette Romp. A hard hammer with the right hand. Boy, what a week she had last week for the Bears. Has been so consistent in her career, three straight with 10. And last year had 19 and hit 405 in the quarterfinal matchup. Wheeler cross court, Halsey. I think she ran into the net. No, instead they call a ball handling error and the bench of LR completely unhappy. And I think there's a pretty decent case to be made there. That didn't look to be anything illegal. But it does work out that way. Carson-Newman's back within a point. And now McKenna Hall, the Wisconsin native, serves. Romp has to stay at the 10-foot line to be able to punch it to the corner. Wheeler rockets it. Great diving play by Hawkins. Allen, though, puts it in the net. And for the first time in the match, we are tied. A rare error from LR, their third attack error so far. They're still hitting 269. Carson-Newman, five kills, no errors so far, though. Carpenter lunges, Hawkins rescues, and Allen will just aid it over the free ball. All ball, once Kieran, off of the tape. Drop, drives it through the block this time. LR maintains the edge. Well, you knew that this one would be tight all night long. You can buckle up for a fascinating match all evening. 13-12 Bears. Carpenter serves. Barton. Now Wheeler from the 10-foot line. Shanked pass, hits the net. Carson-Newman back to level terms. Give that one a kill to Julia Wheeler. That's her second. She's the first Carson-Newman player with multiple kills. The first five have been distributed to five different players. And now Abby Hildenbrand will head back to serve. Four early assists for her. A little bit of maintenance on the floor being taken care of by Braylon Faust. Hildenbrand lofts. Halsey selects the middle and Faust. Barton bump sets, Wheeler tight to the tape, off of the hands. Romp now. Sherry able to gobble it up. Now a back row attack from the sophomore and it goes out of bounds. Back and forth we go. LR's largest lead of the set, four. That was after a 7-3 start. Jump floating serve here from Vaughn. To the middle, Kieran off of the solo block attempt to Faust, and we're tied once more, 14 apiece. We've been tied now at 12, 13, and 14. And it's Julia Wheeler back to serve. Had an ace the first time she was back there. Halsey. Barton, a nice lunging stop. Molly Lankford with a strong swing, and for the first time today, Carson-Newman leads. Lankford's second blast on her second swing. Carson-Newman has battled back to take the lead. And Wheeler sends it out. It is a short-lived margin for the Eagles. Well, both sides hitting above 250 here in the first set. Good match going here. Hildenbrand. Lankford taps. It gets blocked, though. Hawkins combining with Faust. a very interesting matchup, not just in the conference, but when it comes to overall regional action. Out of bounds on the serve. 16 apiece. Always have to consider that. When you look back at last year for Carson-Newman, for example, the reason they didn't make the NCAA tournament really can be boiled down to one match, and that was a loss to Mars Hill in the middle of the season. If the Eagles win that match, odds are they're in. But they didn't, and they failed to make the tournament. This ball never hit Carson-Newman, and they decide to continue to play this on, and it ends up working out because Blake Cherry adds to her kill tally. That's how fine of a line it can be, though, sometimes when it comes to regional positioning. One match determined everything. Now, certainly losing at Catawba late in the year for the Eagles didn't help the cause, and probably solidified them being on the outside looking in. Hawkins with a great swing. And we are tied. Sixth time we've been tied in the last 12 rallies. And it is Faust heading back to serve. Very short points so far here in this match as well. Faust. Langford throws it over, and this ball goes out off the Halsey ricochet. Well, right now it feels like if either side is able to win two or even three in a row at this point, that's going to be the difference in the set. Siding out hasn't been a problem. It's been getting a point on serve. And all ball, the Lees McRae transfer. Dials up an ace. Eagles have their largest lead. Timeout LR. And Carson-Newman, after trailing by four early, has taken the advantage here against the Bears. Things looking around the rest of the league. It's Emery and Henry taking their show on the road to take on Anderson. And the Trojans lead 19-14 in the first. UVA Wise leads at Newberry 18-13 in the first. And that's a Wise club that has the longest active conference losing streak in the nation. Catawba is at Mars Hill, and the Lions lead by four in the opening set. And the only other match on the docket tonight, Limestone hosting Coker. And it's a three-point lead late in the opening frame for the Saints. And those are your four matches going on around the rest of the league. Oh, when you look at the overall conference standings at this point, Carson-Newman certainly has this next week in high regard. You get Lenoir-Rhyne, who right now sits at 8-2 in the league, tied for the third best record in the conference. And then Carson-Newman will face off against a Wingate team that has rattled off 18 straight wins as the Eagles travel to Cuddy Arena next Friday night. Two matches in a row that are critical for the overall landscape of the season. Eagles enter tonight second in the overall standing picture, sitting at 9-1 off to its best start in conference play since the team won the region back in 2015. Eagles took down the Bears in that regional final at Aiken that season. Eagles have won back-to-back points. And here's a shanked pass. Carpenter rescues, and Hawkins able to get it over. Nearly a disaster. Cobb makes no mistakes. Three straight to the Eagles. Emma Grace Cobb gives Carson-Newman some separation in the first. Albaugh doing the job on serve. Really good one, testing the middle. Into the Carson-Newman block, picked back up, thrown over. Cobb gets a piece, Wheeler diving. Cobb deflects. Carson-Newman scrambling right now, and it ends up hitting the ground. Well, Carson-Newman completely out of system that time around. After winning three straight points, Eagles concede that one. And now let's see how the Bears handle things. Down by a deuce in the first. Albaugh. Cherry. Hawkins with the right hand. This is very close to the net. Romp able to avoid the net. Cobb back over for Carson-Newman. Romp this time a full swing and making no mistakes. Four kills for Romp. A match high so far. Back to a one-point opening set. Eagles, Bears, in another decisive one. Cherry through the block. Lake Terry having a fine match. Three kills already. Well, if you remember back to last year's conference tournament match, Carson-Newman won the first set and had a couple set points in the second. And he couldn't put away the Bears' lost sets 2, 3, and 4, and the season came to a crashing close. Halsey, Romp on the slide, keeps it in play, good angle. Well, Colette Romp is doing her part. Five kills so far of LR's 14. Hawkins heads back to serve. Bears so far just one ace for the best service group in the league. All ball. Wheeler. Out of bounds. Official rules a touch to our right-hand side. That is a massive change. Instead of being tied at 21, Carson-Newman leads by two. It was the line judge to our right, and Ashley Hawkins is heading over to the lead official to confirm the call and get an explanation for her coach, Nicole Behringer. At least to the naked eye, it did not look like there was much of anything in that on the LR side. But Wheeler will gladly take a fourth kill. Now McKenna Hall back to serve. Eagles inching closer to an opening set win. Hall, high arcing ball this time around. Halsey will be flat-footed as she serves it up to Romp, who gets stuffed. Halsey was nervous that ball hitting the net. It ends up a free ball. Allbaugh shovels it to the corner. Romp off of the block. Eagles can't find it. Now they do. Hall rescues it over. Eagles scrambling. All ball flops. Romp once more. Out of bounds. And it all comes from the scrappiness of this Eagles group. LR burns its final timeout. And after trailing early, the Eagles have gone on top and are in the driver's seat in the first. Can they close it out? We'll find out when we come back. First set action, Carson-Newman on top, 23-20 here on the Eagles Sports Network. Carson-Newman trailed by 4 points early. Eagles have since found the response that they've needed. And the Eagles with an opportunity to close this one out. Carson-Newman hitting 282. Three kills apiece from Wheeler, Cherry, and Lankford. And now McKenna Hall is heading back to serve for Carson-Newman, looking to close this one out in the opening set. Jump floating opportunity for McKenna Hall. Shank pass. Fourth service ace. 24-20. Set point for the Eagles. 7-3 Carson-Newman run. And a chance to close it out in the opening set. Hall flops it to the corner. Out of the middle, into the net. Attack error. Bears fire. Off a mistake, the Eagles finish on an 8-3 surge, win the final 4 points, and Carson-Newman takes the opening set. Eagles on top, one set to none here at Holt Fieldhouse. We'll step out for a break. Can Carson-Newman keep the good times rolling? Find out with us when we come back to Holt Fieldhouse in a moment.
No, the other one.
Yeah, they all kind of changed.
Yeah. Oh, that was cute. Heads together. Two people laying opposite ways. Their heads were the side together.
Let me find it, please. Let me find it.
Carson-Newman pulls away in the first set. Eagles trailed for the majority of it. Didn't take their first lead until 15-14 in the opening game. And Carson-Newman able to close it out, winning 8 of the final 11 points, including the last four, winning 25-20. So now here in set number two, can Carson-Newman keep things rolling along? After hitting 282 as a group, it's Blake Cherry to start us off. Michael Watrang with you and our entire crew elated you to sign and spend part of your Friday with us. Wheeler pokes. Carson-Newman making a plea that it was touched. It is an unsuccessful plea. How do the Bears respond? Carson Newman's won 19 consecutive sets now. All ball for Cobb and a net violation on Carson Newman. Might have been Cobb that got that knee up into the net. Lenoir-Rhyne didn't realize it was their serve. But indeed it is. Comes Hawkins again. Barton gets a piece. Cherry saves it. And Wheeler hits it out. Three in a row to LR. And this second set starting much the way the first set started, where LR won 7 of the first 10 points. And we're in control early. Hawkins again. Out of bounds this time. Carson Newman on the scoreboard here in the second. Because of the way that the season broke out, with this being a year where all teams for fall sports are meeting in one location for the final tournament site, season gets started in August. We're chugging towards the end of the year already. Hildenbrand, it's Wheeler. Now Romp through the hands of Hall, and a 4-1 start for the Bears. At it for Carson-Newman. Get this match. And just two matches in the month of November as Wheeler drives this one to the ground. Violation was whistled on LR. So the season winding down just a little bit. Not many weekends to go to improve upon the resume. Eagles angling for a 20-win season. Romp. Rescued by Wheeler. Molly Langford, who's had a really good start. Romp chips it over. Barton for Wheeler. Halsey again having to avoid the tape. Kieran Halsey overpass. Cherry keeps it in. I think that ball would have stayed in as well. And then Langford hits it out of bounds. That was a tough decision there for Cherry. Had to go over her back, sprint towards the end line. And I think where she contacted it it would have fallen just inside of the back tape. And because of that, Carson-Newman is down by three in the second after winning the first set. Wheeler steps back, bounces it off the high hands. Faust through the block of Wheeler and Kieran. LR off to a good start. One thing that Carson-Newman has done exceptionally well at all season long, and it's a big credit to this group and the maturation that has been seen. They have finished sets so strong all year. Wheeler. How about Halsey's left shoulder keeping it alive? Hildenbrand. Wheeler. Out of bounds. Third attack error from Wheeler in the set. Carson-Newman is calling for time, so we'll step out for a break as well. 7-2 start to the second set. Bears cruising. And Carson-Newman regain its rhythm and form? Find out with us when we return. Bears on top in the second, down a set to none here on the Eagle Sports Network. LR won 7 of the first 10 in the first set. They've won 7 of the first 9 in the second set. Eagles have dug themselves a hole yet again. They came back in the first. Wheeler finds the arms of Carpenter. Back row attack from Vaughn. Wheeler once more. Carpenter. Another response, and then Hawkins flares. Langford. Good scrappiness here. One of the longer rallies we've had. Cherry rescuing it. Langford threw it over, and then Halsey. What great decision making, and so alert by the setter, the senior from Sanford, North Carolina, Lee County High School. Sensed that all of Carson-Newman players were on one side and used the other. Wheeler. Out of bounds, and Julia Wheeler making mistakes, and she's going to have to be replaced in the lineup. Four attack errors for Julia Wheeler in this set, and it's Taylor Adams coming into the match, and Wheeler will get a brief break to regroup. 9-2 start for LR. Immediately testing Adams. Kieran keeping the hang time up there, getting the right paw to it, flicking it to the left-hand side. That stops a little bit of the bleeding. It was a 5-0 LR run. And a 9-2 start. Eagles need to get some things going now. Adams. Faust. Out of the middle, no resistance whatsoever. And Julia Wheeler is going to come back into the match and replace Taylor Adams. But here's one of the things about Carson-Newman that you have to look at. Wheeler has 24 attacks. No other player on the roster has 8. It's a lot of weight on her shoulders. She's held on to it so strong all year. Cherry flies it through the 10-foot line. That was a great angled swing by Blake Cherry. LR in control in the second. Aiden Barton on serve. Hawkins bounces it off of the hardwood. Boy, LR getting some really good swings now. And Carson-Newman's block hasn't been up to the task. Well, neither side an overly strong blocking unit. LR 7th in the league in blocks. Haven't had a double-digit block effort all year. Should be an offensive match between these two. Sherry hits it off the blockade. Halsey, great diving effort. Eagles keep it alive, and then Wheeler flicks it into the net. Well, it worked out so well for Carson-Newman for just a moment. Another attack error, and Julia Wheeler, the conference's leader in kills, has four of them, but five errors now in this set. And Faust on serve with LR cruising in the second. Langford, Faust, a good pass. Hawkins, net violation on Carson-Newman. Well, there's a lot of unforced errors happening on the Carson-Newman side of the net. And the Eagles face a 9-point deficit. Carson-Newman has not lost a set since September 13th. 19 in a row. And down big in the second. Hildenbrand, Emma Grace Cobb. Easy answer for her. Just her second kill. One of the more efficient players in the conference. Ranking in the top 10 entering today. Now Carly Allball back into the match. Had a great 2 years at Lees McRae and transferring here to Carson-Newman. Her brother was a kicker at Lenoir-Rhyne, the all-time leading scorer in Bears history. Hawkins crushes another one. 14-5. An utter pummeling right now by this LR side, and Carson-Newman is forced to take another timeout. So the Eagles are out of timeouts, trailing by 9 in the second. Updating you on things from around the league after Anderson cruised to a first set win over Emory and Henry, 25-17. 16-10 leaders in the second. Jalen Grimm leading the way with 5 kills. So chance for Anderson to go up 2-0. UVA Wise snares a set from Newberry, 27-25 in the first. In the second, the Wolves on top by a point. And it's the team's leader, Kaylee Scarce, leading the way with 5 kills for the Cavs. Mars Hill won the opening set, 27-25 against Catawba. Now the Lions are down 8-4 in the second. Jana Cook with 4 kills. And elsewhere around the league, Limestone wins the first 25-19 and lead 11-9 in the second set. And being led by Mia McMillan, 9 kills, hitting 421 at the outset. Here at Holt Fieldhouse, Carson-Newman is in a major hole. LR hitting 368, 7 kills. Carson-Newman has 7 attack errors in the set. Wheeler, Allbaugh for Cobb. Hildenbrand spins. Sherry pushes. Rob. Allbaugh to the back. And a violation on Carson-Newman. Second time in the match. Our lead official has not liked how a setter has handled a ball, trying to fillet it to the corner. 15-5. Bears in control. Sherry, it's stuffed. This time it's Wheeler from the back row. That's a block that stays in. Just the second block of the match for LR. And with all the activities happening on that side of the floor, really no answers for Carson-Newman. And the Eagles hitting 106 now overall for the match. Sherry from the right pin gets blocked, goes out of bounds. Carson-Newman ends a 3-0 surge by the Bears. The Eagles need a lot more of that right now. Carson-Newman down by 10 in the second. And Cherry sends it to Carpenter. Did Carson-Newman touch this ball? The officials haven't officially decided yet. The Eagles did not touch it. The two officials had a conversation, and really no argument from LR. despite the fact that they probably wanted to. Hawkins puts an end to that little surge. Carson-Newman had one back-to-back. And Hawkins has another one. Well, it's great balance right now from the Bears. Hawkins has 7 kills, Romp with 6. Faust and Holsey with 3 apiece, Clark with 2. Hildenbrand. Well, Lars block has been good. Carson-Newman maybe a little predictable right now. Wheeler getting back on track as she slides one through the block. Well, Wheeler came in averaging nearly 5 kills per set. Roll over 4.5. That was her 5th. Mistakes have been a big part of the issue. On her 27 swings, 6 errors. Net violation wouldn't have mattered. Emily Allen. That ball had a lot of velocity behind it. And LR in control and not letting off the harness at all is another block. Kieran, really not much she can do with that one. Very tight to the tape. Bears won the first 3 and 9 of the first 11. 15 of the first 20, and sitting here on top by 11. Well, if you're Lenoir-Rhyne, you don't want to give Carson-Newman any kind of confidence going throughout the rest of this set. And Abby Hildenbrand heads back to serve. Romp uses the fist to get it over. Barton is going to select Wheeler, and she bangs it off of the back line of Halsey. Well, if you're not going to get a block up against Wheeler and give her some confidence after some unforced errors, very difficult to slow her down. All-region selection. Romp finessing. Hawkins, great effort. Over to the bleachers. Really good work there by Hawkins. Just couldn't get enough on it. She might have hit something as well. She's coming up maybe a little bit limp after that, flexing the legs. Maybe it got in the right knee. Carpenter into the block. It's Carson Newman's rejection of Lankford and Kieran. 3 in a row by the Eagles. Not quite done yet. In a set in which Carson-Newman has done nothing well. Trying to pull this thing back. Flicked over. Allen gets responded to. Halsey sends Cherry chasing. Lankford off of the block. 4 straight by Carson-Newman. Still a 6-point set, but momentum back on Carson-Newman's side. Another point or two here in a row. And this thing could get interesting. After being down by double figures for a chunk of this set, Romp out of the middle. Eagles block does well to slow it down. Wheeler's caught fire of late. Carpenter cannot handle it. Eagles have won 5 unanswered, have trimmed the margin to 5. And LR calls for time. Well, I just said it moments ago. Carson-Newman's ability to close sets has been so critical this season. So strong at the end. Is the deficit too large to overcome? It's been as many as 11 on a few occasions. And it's currently 6 unanswered since it was 19-8. Carson-Newman fans trying to rally around this group. Eagles looked really good in the first after not leading until it was 15-14. Carson-Newman closed on an 8-3 outburst. These 6 straight points have been much needed. But the Bears still lead it by 5. if you're LR here, you probably need a couple points in a row to stymie this surge by the Eagles. If Carson-Newman cannot win this one, another 3 or 4-0 stretch would get them right back into it. Romp off of the block. Well, where else would you go than the conference's offensive player of the week this week in Colette Romp, who dominated Carson-Newman last year in the conference quarterfinals. 19 kills, 405 hitting clip. This is going to be Cherry from the back row. Eagles were out of system. Back row from Hawkins. Hildenbrand gets it. It hit the ceiling. Barton with a good reaction. But a free ball. Faust through the Carson-Newman block. And just as Carson-Newman had won six straight, it's back-to-back by the Bears. And they are back in the driver's seat firmly. Leading by seven and only needing four more to win the set. Wheeler rifles it towards the corner. Vaughn out of the back row. Barton getting to it. It has to be a free ball because Cherry had it back up. Halsey flicks over on a pair. Wheeler slices it just inside of the hands of Carpenter. 21-15. And Julia Wheeler has responded well. She had a stretch where she had, I think it was four consecutive attack errors. You know, she's up to eight kills now. Faust. Langford. Overpass. Cherry. It's Kieran putting it down. 21-16. Well, since it was 19-8, Carson-Newman has won eight of the last 10. Is it too little, too late? Halsey. Langford, I don't know how that ball even went over the net. And Wheeler can't get there as Faust shimmies it to the corner. ...22-16. Very short serve. Eagles have to scramble. Wheeler sends a free ball over. Faust. Sidearm hack. Langford waits. Hook shot. Blocked. Wheeler somehow got a pretty good swing. Nearly put it away. Carpenter. Free ball. That ball was probably going out. Kieran, though, makes it a non-issue. Taylor Kieran, a kill. Her fifth. She's having a really good match. Five kills, nine swings, just one error. 22-17. LR still within striking distance of closing this one out. Eagles could use another one of those little 6-0 runs. And it's an ace to start off this sequence. 22-18. Well, so often, you get up big, you start to fall asleep. How often do you see that in volleyball? All you're trying to do is just hold on now. Halsey wants Faust, and Faust makes no mistakes. And the Bears within a pair. Well, it's been an offensive match. So far, we've seen 42 kills between the two sides. Last year, both teams averaged over 13 kills per set in the quarterfinal matchup. Cobb gets blocked. Cobb blocked again, still able to aid it over. Then a block and a violation. And frustration for Carson-Newman. Well, it's a terrific close to the set regardless. But the Bears have a chance to put the finishing touches on this. Right now leading 24-19 and looking to hand Carson-Newman its first set loss since September 13th. And it will not come right now. ...24-19. And it's Carly all ball on serve. Eagles have five aces. Need a strong service game. Halsey. Waiting on it, Hawkins. And she gets it to the corner. And that, as they say, is that. Carson-Newman's stretch of sweeps is done. And we're tied at a set apiece. The Eagles drop the second. First set loss for Carson-Newman since September 13th. A good work by the Bears. They hit 293 in the second. We're all level through two sets. Who can take the upper hand in the third? Is it Carson-Newman or is it Lenoir-Rhyne? Another Danny Brewing in the all-time series. Step out for a break. Come back, including an 8-2 burst in the second. But the hole was too large for the Eagles to overcome. And with Carson-Newman and Lenoir-Rhyne tied at a set apiece, we open up the third. And it'll be Halsey back on serve. Critical third set here at Holt Fieldhouse. Halsey serves, Wheeler controls. Hildenbrand, she's been fairly quiet from the pin positions. Just her second kill, 13 assists, 12 digs for Hildenbrand so far. And for the first time today, the Eagles have won the opening point of a set. Cherry back to serve. Blake flicks it up there, and it's an ace. Sixth of the match for Carson-Newman. Well, Carson-Newman has been tied after two sets twice this year, a win and a loss. 13-7 under Coach Tiernan. Another quality serve from Cherry. On the slide, flung on over, and it bounces off the hardwood from Emma Clark. That's the primetime matchup in the league. Of course, you have the division records that you have to funnel in as well when it comes to division standing. So Mars Hill's still technically the top team in the division over Carson-Newman because they haven't lost to the Mountain Division so far. 3-1. And McKenna Hall heads back to serve. A hard block. Hildenbrand and Kieran. Big time rejection on the right pin. Hildenbrand getting to the top. Eagles have won four of the first five out of the third. All who's been a great server in her career. Another challenging one. Romp gets a pretty good swing on it. Hildenbrand wants Wheeler. And sliding to the ground was Hawkins. She did the splits. I think she slipped on some perspiration. Pancake City from Alba, but can't get enough of it. And LR benefits there because Hawkins was going to need a bit of a second as she slid to the ground. And I think they're going to ask for the Gatorade towel here to wipe up some moisture. That was actually pretty impressive work out of the back by LR because I think the expectation was that Hawkins was going to get to that ball, but she did the splits and Carpenter rescue. For the first six to the Eagles in the third. Carson-Newman won 25-20 in the first. Lost 25-19 in the second. Carpenter. Backpedaling is Barton. Wheeler out of the middle. That was an annihilation of the ball. Julia Wheeler reverberates the gym. Oh, when Wheeler gets a hold of a ball, you're going to know about it. That's a match high, 9 kills now. Right pin set, drop off of the block. Eagles keep it in play. Now it is flicked on over by Allen. Langford, Hildenbrand somehow kept it alive. Romp, Hildenbrand wants Wheeler again. Blocked by the Eagles. Langford and Kieran. Eagles with their second block already in the set. Six, two. Carson-Newman on top in the third. By far their best start to a set in the match. Romp. Stop! Back-to-back blocks. Kieran Wheeler this time around. And it's Carson-Newman this time that gets off to a hot start. Out of the middle, Faust. Carson-Newman stuffs it. This one, though, goes out of play. 7-3. Great to have you with us tonight with our entire crew. I'm Michael Watrang watching this one with you. Hope you're enjoying your Friday evening. Glad you're spending some time with us here on the Eagle Sports Network. Kieran Carpenter sends it into the seats. Taylor Kieran's having a fine effort. 6 kills, second most on the team. Carson-Newman this year has gotten a lot of great play out of the middle, mostly from Emma Grace Cobb. And Kieran playing her part today. Wheeler did enough to keep that one around. It is a free ball, though. Does this one go over? It does. Touched by LR. Or was it touched? I thought Kieran had it bounce off of a bear, and it did not. Officials all over it. And it's Carson-Newman ahead by 4. And an error here, 9-4. Carson-Newman on top here in the third. Eagles offense much better here in this set than it was in set 2. Halsey to Ashley Hawkins, out of bounds. Fourth attack error for LR. And it is a timeout here. Nicole Behringer calls for time. We'll step out for a break as well. Carson-Newman leads 10-4. Third set, looking to go ahead 2-1 and break the 1-1 tie. Hang with us. Eagles and Bears locked up in another good one. Carson-Newman rolling. 3 kills, 3 blocks here in this third set after falling behind big in each of the first 2 sets. It's Carson-Newman opening up a frame with a big margin. And Tayden Barton back on serve. Bounce off of the block. Faust with her 8th. She's yet to misfire. Getting over 500 now in the match. And now she's back to serve and hits it out of play. Well, if you remember back to last year, the conference quarterfinals, Carson-Newman cruised in the first, lost the second, and never could regain its form. To flip the script here tonight after winning the first, dropping the second, ahead in the third. Clark swing. This is Hildenbrand. Cobb got a piece, Carpenter. Back row attack from Allen. Hildenbrand right pin. Allen playing very deep. Halsey sends it over. Sherry stuffed. The Eagles somehow able to rescue it. Wheeler went rolling into the bench. Out of bounds. Well, the effort of Julia Wheeler rescued the point, and Carson-Newman is on top by 7. There's a hard swing from Hawkins. 12-6. Hawkins, her ninth kill. Tied with Wheeler for a match high. One more kill away from a double-double as she has 15 digs already. Sherry, did it get a touch? It did. 13-6. Sherry with her sixth kill has 10 digs as well to tie for the team lead. She serves it, and this is an ace ending up in the third row of the bleachers. Seventh ace of the match. How about this here tonight? LR entered this contest ranked in the top spot in the league, 28th in the country, 2.22 aces per set. They only have one in the match. Sherry sends this one into the net. 14-7. The service game hasn't necessarily been a point scoring part of the procedure right now for LR. All ball for Emma Grace Cobb. Nobody over there for LR, and an easy one for Emma Grace. Third kill for the Greensboro, North Carolina native. McKenna Hall back on serve. All ball now with a double-double, 10 assists, 10 digs. All ball did an excellent job to absorb that ball. Rop off of the block. Eagles couldn't close it. Carson-Newman 15, Lenoir-Rhyne 8. Hildenbrand. Rock. All ball angles for Hildenbrand. Now Kieran. Oh, it's a great play by Hawkins as she was caught wrong footed but couldn't get it towards her teammates. Carson-Newman doubling up LR. Do the Bears have that kind of surge that Carson-Newman had in them in the second set to make this thing interesting? Romp starts it off with another blast. Eighth for Romp. On a red shirt freshman serves. It's Kieran off of the block. Carson-Newman's been in rhythm in the attack. Seven kills in the set. 32 for the match. Faust. There's Hildenbrand's 14th dig. Langford. This time Hawkins. Back row attack. Wheeler. Off of the net. No Carson-Newman touch. And an attack error from Vaughn. Lenoir-Rhyne calls for time. Bears now out of timeouts with Carson-Newman on top. Eagles lead it 18-9 in the third. Scores from around the league real quick. Anderson's within 3 points of sweeping Emory and Henry. 22-10 leaders, Noel Knudsen. 7 kills, 8 swings, 875 hitting percentage leads the way for Anderson. Newberry takes the second set and lead it 10-7 in the third, looking to go ahead 2-1. Hall and Schaefer each with 10 kills. Scarce with 11 for Wise. Catawba won the second set against Mars Hill 25-23. They just started the third, so that match is tied at a set apiece. And Limestone up 2-0, leads 11-9 in the third. McMillan still leading all players with 16 kills in that matchup. So that's what's going on around the rest of the conference right now. Here, Carson-Newman had won 19 consecutive sets before LR controlled and dominated, leading wire to wire in the second set. winning it 25-19 despite a little bit of a late surge by Carson Newman. And now here in the third set, it's been all Eagles from start to finish. And looking to polish this thing off, leaving it 18-9. And Wheeler sends it out of play, out of the LR timeout. Bears have no more timeouts to go, as Allen will head back to serve. Just 3 kills and 6 errors for Allen, who answered as the top player on the roster at 3 kills per set. Langford block, Barton rescues. Cherry gets another one. 7th kill for Blake Cherry. Cherry having a fine match. Really everybody on Carson Newman's roster providing a lot. Barton, 6 digs, 5 assists, and a couple aces as she serves. Hawkins, blocked out of bounds. 18-11. Faust, back to serve. Clipping the top of the tape. Cherry. Faust, unorthodox, use the right arm. Hawkins, a roll shot. Cobb gets blocked and hits the shoulder. Cherry, what an effort by LR to keep it alive. Cherry, down the line. Despite the ricocheting balls of LR, it's Blake Cherry with her 8th. 20-11. Eagles closing in on going in control. 2-1. As we get ready, perhaps, for a decisive 4th set. Hawkins. Out of bounds. Nobody on the Eagles side touched it. 21-11. All ball, ready to serve it. Hawkins just pokes it. That ball nearly was perfect. And the overpass of Barton, who did everything she could to save it, is responded by a Clark Punisher. Well, not much you can do right there if you're Carson Newman. Nobody was on that side of the floor, and Barton did all she could just to get to it. Cherry. Hawkins. All ball steps in front of Cobb, and Cherry hits it out of bounds. And they call a touch. I don't know about that one. Didn't look like anybody for LR got a piece. That ball looked like it was way above the Bears' hands. Cherry. Hawkins into the net. LR uncharacteristically inaccurate. 10 kills, 8 errors here in this 3rd set. Cherry once more sends it over off of the tape this time. Hawkins. Eagles do get a touch this time around. Bears the kill. Ashley Hawkins back to serve. Wheeler. Pretty quiet here in this set. Hildenbrand knuckles it. Romp, Halsey out of bounds. Carson Newman gets another one. And set point now here in the 3rd. McKenna Hall back to try to put the finishing touches on this and send the Eagles ahead. 2-1. All ready to dial this one up. Blocked. Taylor Kieran Eagles take the third, and Carson Newman's on top, 2-1. Carson Newman blows out the Bears in the third, and now a set away from putting the finishing touches on this. Does LR have a response again? They did after the first set. We're going to find out when we come back. Fourth set action from Holt Fieldhouse coming your way when we come back on the Eagle Sports Network. Carson Newman looking to close this match out, leading it 2-1 as Carly Albaugh serves in the fourth. Right side set, Rob getting things started with the plomb. Colette Rob, 10th kill of the night. Can Carson Newman put the finishing touches on this one and not allow this to go to a fifth? We'll find out here in a moment. Wheeler backpedals. Nobody for Carson Newman in double figures yet. Sherry and Wheeler each with 9. Out of bounds. Well, despite all of the festivities here and big surges, there were no ties nor lead changes in either of the second or third sets. LR leading wire to wire in the second, Carson Newman in the third. This ball put to the ground by Clark. Well, with that in mind, we would think perhaps this might be time where we do get one of those back and forth sets. Wheeler drops it down. Was a net violation on LR as well. The official stat reads kill. That'd be the 10th for Julia. No region selection. McKenna Hall back to serve. Carson-Newman and LR level. Vaughn. No touch. Carson-Newman point. Lenoir-Rhyne hitting a buck 92 right now in the match. This is a team this year that has hit at least 250 eight times in 17 matches entering tonight. Rock blocked. Wheeler and Kieran. Ninth rejection of the match for Carson-Newman. How about the day that Taylor Kieran is having right now? Kieran, 8 kills. She's hitting 583. She also has 5.5 total blocks. Back row attack, Hawkins. Hildenbrand flings it over. All ball. Kieran. Romp. Hall there. And that one finds some empty space. Julia Wheeler. Carson-Newman's won four straight. And now McKenna Hall heads back to serve. Eagles have won 5 of the first 7 points. Out of bounds. First time in the match, we see Lindsay Warren, the freshman from Lincolnton, North Carolina. She's serving for LR. Kieran got a piece of the ricochet up top. Cherry, a bump set. Hildenbrand spins and finds space. Abby Hildenbrand with her fourth kill. Carson-Newman on top by 3, looking to put the finishing touches on this match. Abby Hildenbrand heads back to serve. 17 assists, 14 digs. Within 5 now of 1,000 digs for the career. Faust, there's dig 15 of the night. 996 for the career for Hildenbrand. And there's a kill out of the back row from Blake Cherry. She has a double-double. 10 and 12 now. Kills and digs for Blake Cherry. Her first double-digit kill effort since September 3rd against North Greenville. This ball goes out of play. Newman in control again, and a timeout from LR. Eagles on top, 8-3 in the fourth. Eagles looking to put this thing down. Stepping out for a break. Carson-Newman on top and looking to put this thing away when we come back on the Eagle Sports Network. Carson-Newman has played nearly flawlessly in the last two sets. How about this? 15 kills, 35 swings, no errors in sets 3 and set 4. And Carson-Newman in that stretch is plus 17 on LR. Vaughn into the block. out of bounds. Unforced miscues from the Bears. Four in a row again for Carson Newman. After we were tied at two, this is a 7-1 burst. Vaughn again, Barton. It is Wheeler. Warren hits it, it goes through the net. Five unanswered by Carson Newman. And now a 9-1 Carson Newman stretch since trailing 2-1. Wheeler there to gobble it up. Kieran keeps it in play in the corner. Six in a row by Carson Newman. And a 10-1 outburst. Bears with no answers right now. Into the net. Well, LR has just continued to rack up misfires. While Carson Newman has been basically flawless, LR has 14 errors in the last two sets alone. Hildenbrand, a sprawling stop. Great effort by Abby. Into the block here. Flopped over the head of Hildenbrand to Cherry. Wheeler, really good work. Three balls sent over. Hildenbrand picks out Kieran. Inbounds as Vaughn finally stops the bleeding. 12-4 though. Carson Newman wins seven straight and 11 of 12. And Carson Newman feeling it right now, looking to put this thing away. Hildenbrand for Kieran. She's blocked. Faust at the middle. Just the fourth block for LR. It's really the only point where LR has not been really strong this year is the block. Seventh in the league. Wheeler from the right pin. It hits the outside of the antenna, and Julia Wheeler has her 13th kill. Hasn't always been crisp from Julia here today, but she's done enough as she serves, and it's an ace. Second ace of the match for Wheeler. 14-5. And this has turned into a rout here in the fourth. Bears have no answer. Another shank pass from Carpenter. Back-to-back aces. Carson Newman has started 15-5 in the fourth. Wheeler. Right side set. Faust block! Blake Cherry. What a performance by the Eagles on defense. Cherry with her second block. Overall, great effort from Blake Cherry. And the Eagles on top by 11. Well, Cherry, we know how talented she can be. This season, just three efforts with double-digit kills. And she had six in her last two matches. And hadn't been hitting all that efficiently. She'd been hitting under 100 in her last four, but now hitting 346, and she has given the Eagles a lift. Taylor Kieran's block has been next level as well. And Carson Newman is on top by 11 in the fourth. And an opportunity to pin this one down and finish it off. LR, no more timeouts. Carson Newman in full control, 9 points away from closing this one out. And Wheeler will head back to serve. Three aces, 13 kills. Wheeler, ready to light it up. Back-to-back aces. Carpenter, a better pass this time. And off of the block is Hawkins. Such a steep hill to climb now for LR. Do the Bears have any kind of burst in them? 16-6. Raylan Faust serving. Wheeler passes. Kieran through the block, muscles it through. She has her 10th kill of the night. Kieran with a strong performance. Really doing a little bit of it all in this one as she has her third double-digit kill effort of the year. Barton serves. Barton gets a piece. Sherry rescues with a great hustle and a right-handed roll over her shoulder. And then it's into the net. I'll tell you what, when points like that are going Carson Newman's way, no answers for Lenoir-Rhyne. Carson Newman with a vengeance here in this set. Langford. Hawkins through the hands of Barton. Couldn't decide what she wanted to do with it. Whether or not she wanted to get her arms down or up. It went right through her body. 18-7. Halsey serves. Langford off of the block. Sherry. Sherry again. Cobb punches. Rob. Carson Newman making the argument perhaps it hit the antenna, and the officiating crew does not agree. 18-8. Halsey once more serving. Sherry. Empty space there. Nobody for LR had an answer. 19-8. Carly Allball with a double-double. 12 assists, 14 digs. One of the three Eagles with one today. Through the block here. Hawkins, 14th kill for Ashley Hawkins. Look at LR. Top three have produced, Hawkins, Rop, and Faust combining for 33 of the team's 47 kills, but everybody else hitting under 100 or negative. Sherry had to wait on it, and she hits it out of play. Bears within nine. There's Newman limiting LR to a 147 hitting margin right now. One of the more efficient teams in the league. Cobb with a good swing. It's an overpass that goes out of bounds. The lowest percentages of the year for LR. Season low for the Bears, 111 at Wingate. They've lost every match when they hit below 145. All ball. Cobb dunks it. Fourth for Emma Grace Cobb. 21-10. Well, it doesn't appear as if the Bears are going to have any kind of late burst in them. This ball way out of play. Haley Carpenter serves. Hildenbrand nudges it over. Diving stop Carpenter. Romp gets another one. 12th for Romp. 21-12. Romp having another nice match. about Hawkins this day? 14 kills, 20 digs, match high. All ball for the middle and Cobb. Not sure if you're going to credit Carson-Newman on that, regardless. It hits the side. 22-12. Eagles on top. McKenna Hall readies. Right side set, Rob. All ball. Wheeler. Out of bounds. Misfires continue. 23-12. Cruise control for Carson-Newman. All ready to go. Carpenter overpass. Kieran. Net violation. Match point here in the fourth. 24-12, fourth set. Hall will try to wrap it up. And here comes the effort of McKenna Hall. Gives it up for Bailey Carpenter. Vaughn off of Carson Newman's hands. All ball once Hildenbrand. She puts it down. Carson Newman finishes it off. The Eagles nearly flawless in the final two sets. Wrap it up against the Bears, and Carson Newman continues to ride high. Win number 7 in a row for the Eagles. And now Carson Newman will get a week to get ready for the 22nd ranked team of the country in the Wingate Bulldogs. Carson Newman wins 25-12 in the fourth, and they win it in four. Wraps this up on our broadcast. Carson-Newman football's in action tomorrow afternoon, 1:30 at Tusculum. We'll be on the air at 12:30 on CNEagles.com/live. Hope you join in for that broadcast. For our entire crew tonight, Carson-Newman sweeps the Bears. 25-12, the final score in the fourth. Eagles win it. Signing off, I'm Michael Watrain. We'll talk to you again later. Good night, everybody.